Hello and welcome to the Luxury Hybrid channel. On this channel, I love to have discussions about fashion, beauty, and life. Family and friends call me Didi, and I hope that you will too. In this video, I'm going to show you what I wear in a week. Let's start with Monday. This is the day after my work weekend, so it was for sure a casual day. Since I was feeling so relaxed and all I had to do was just run to physical therapy, I wasn't in the mood for a full glam face. However, glam or no glam, I always fill in my eyebrows with the e.l.f. Ultra Precise Brown Pencil. I like to use it on freshly washed skin before I've done my makeup or my skincare because I find that it tends to grip on my skin and last longer with my oily complexion. I'm very excited to be sharing Merit Beauty Cosmetics with you. They reached out and offered to make me a Merit Muse and gifted me their entire line of cosmetics. This entire line is cruelty-free and vegan. If you go back to my past Sephora haul videos, you will see that cruelty-free and vegan is something I've always strived to achieve when choosing my makeup and my skincare. On this day, I was just in the mood to use their foundation sticks and mascara. I got two different shades, a lighter shade in the color Sand and a darker shade in the color Suede, which is just one step up from the color Sand. The purpose was because I wanted to use a lighter color more towards the T-zone area around my eyes and around my nose, and then use the darker color on the parameters of my face to give depth and dimension, almost as if to imitate where the sun would hit. I'm very excited about their foundation formula because it allows you to skip the concealer step. Since they formulated a two-in-one product, that this makes me really excited, especially because in previous videos, you would have seen me pile on extra foundation underneath my eyes, specifically because of the fact that I don't like the way that concealer looks anymore. Plus, I'm no beauty guru, so I'd rather just stick to one step. I really appreciate the quality of this luxury brand beauty makeup. The foundation sticks come in 20 different colors. If you find yourself in between colors, you can customize, and the possibilities are completely endless. You can have your winter color, you can have your summer color, or you can get a few so that you can contour and add depth and dimension to your look. Because I no longer go for beauty treatments, I needed to make certain that I was satisfied with the foundation and mascara at least before I brought it to you. When I'm doing my lashes, I like to go in with a curler, not all the way toward the root of my lash, a little bit above that, and then I work my best to curl all the way out to the tip. The part I was most nervous about was their mascara. Would it live up to the lengthening that would suit my satisfaction, especially since I don't go for eyelash extensions anymore? I like to go over one eye with the first coat of mascara and let that dry. While I'm letting that dry, I tend to go over my other eye with the first coat, and then I allow for that to dry. And then I work over a second coat on both eyes from midway of my lash all the way up to the tip. And the end is a beautiful result. The finish on this foundation leaves me with a your skin but better look. I love the way my skin looks, and I love the fact that people compliment me and tell me that my skin looks good, not that my makeup looks good. Monday had a slight chill in the air, so I opted for a black hoodie sweatshirt, a pair of denim jeans, and my Vans sneakers. My sidekick for the day was my Louis Vuitton Pochette Métis. It makes the perfect on-the-go errands bag. Tuesday was still a chill day for me. I just had physical therapy before I headed into work. So even though I kept it comfy, I wanted to add a touch more dimension to my previous look the day before. I added the Merit highlighter in the shade Bounce. I really love this minimalist beauty approach on days like this when there just isn't enough time, or just for lazy days when all I need is a less than more makeup routine. So I headed out the door in a camel colored sweatshirt with a white tee untucked. This color combo is an idea that I got from an architectural design magazine. I wore my BP faux leather leggings from last year's summer's Nordstrom sale. This is a style they always seem to carry. Then I added the cat eye sunglasses just because I felt like it pulled the faux leather leggings together. And I finished it off with a pair of Vans and my Louis Vuitton pochette Matisse. These two seemed to make the perfect pairing. Wednesday, I was having Hamptons vibes. To match my mood, I wore my white polo shirt from Hermes and the cropped denim cargo pants from White House Black Market. It went perfectly with my Veja trainers that I always complement with my Hermes Eveline TPM. This outfit had me feeling more inspired in my appearance, so I added the Merit cream blush to my natural look. I have to admit that I was extremely intimidated by this because I wasn't sure how the cream blush would interact with my oily skin. But not only was the pigment payoff impressive, it also lasted all day without moving. It even has a dual purpose, so I used it as a lip stain rather than reaching for a lip gloss that day. Knowing that Merit Beauty is free of 1,328 common toxins banned in the EU, and that their products are artificial fragrance free, paraben and sulfate free, plus it's safe for sensitive skin, is truly a relief for someone like me who lives with hypothyroidism. The less toxins in my sensitive body chemistry, the better. Thursday, I opted for my Tory Burch slides to go with my beloved Tory Burch crossbody bag and the White House Black Market denim look flowy tee. To tie the look together, I decided to recycle my denim jeans I wore from Monday. Merit Beauty is also dedicated to being kind to our planet, the only one we have, by also using recycled packaging and offering a fashionable and reusable washable makeup pouch that is included with your first purchase. I wanted to use my Hourglass palette with this makeup. The lightest shade is something that I love to put on my eyelids. I find that it gives me a nice eye-opening effect without really having to put too much makeup on, especially when you're not in the mood for eyeshadow. I love the finely milled formula because it doesn't get caught in the creases of your eye. And I decided to top it off with the Charlotte Tilbury setting spray because I knew I would be going into several establishments that required me to wear a mask. That means a lot of on and off with the mask in between each place and getting into my car. Friday was an interesting day to say the least. At first it was raining, then it was sunny, then it was windy, it was hot, it was cold. I didn't know how to keep up, so the best way I figured was to wear a sweater vest from Shein, layered under with a black V-neck Uniqlo tee, a pair of black skinny jeans, and my Chanel espadrilles. To keep my hair in check, since the weather was so unpredictable, I added a silky satin scarf wrapped around my hair. And to keep in line with the color scheme, I opted for the Tory Burch crossbody bag once again. This time, I used the entire line of the Merit Beauty Cosmetics and added the bronzer from my Hourglass Ambient palette to deepen the hollows of my cheeks. I also went in with the banana shade from my Makeup Shayla Tardius palette for my under eye and along my T-zone, then the lightest contour shade at my hairline. Last but not least was the Merit Beauty Lip Shine. I thought that it added a nice subtle pop of color to my very neutral attire. I love the fact that every time I use Merit Beauty, it makes me feel as though I'm actually providing self-care and not just putting on makeup. The effort they put into making products that are safe for our skin, body, and the planet makes me so proud to be a part of the Merit Beauty family. They have provided me with an affiliate link that you will find in the description box below. Thank you for watching and stay safe.